In the previous section, we learned how to digitize rasters and to tailor to built up surfaces. When we have scan map, how do we digitize scan map? So that's what we'll be learning in this tutorial. So as we learned previously, would create a new folder. I'll call this folder Nigeria. Now on this particular folder, we'll create a new personal geodatabase and I call it Nigeria GDB. Now we right click again and we come to new and create a feature data set and I call this Nigeria DB DS. And since I'm dealing with a country, I'll be using WGS84. Then select next, then select next, then I set the default and finish. Now I right click again and I create feature classes. So now for the feature classes, I'll be having states, since that's my since that's what I want to digitize the states. Then you can give it an alias if you deem fit. Then for this, the feature type would be polygon for the states. Then press next. So now we can have the attributes we want for the states. Can have name, which will be text, and I know the name of any state is no more than 25 characters, so I leave that as 25. Then we can have the population, and population will be short integer. We can have any other field we really want to have. So I'll just leave this name and population or we can also have geo zone. We can have the geopolitical zone. We can permit spaces, that's why I use the underscore. Then for the geo zone to be text. We finish this. Also, after creating states, I'd like to create another feature class. So the state is catering for polygons. Now let's create something that will cater for lines. Let's say rail track, and this will be line. Okay, again we can have spaces. Okay, so we can have the name. Okay, and finish that. And finally, let's cater for points, since we'll be using point lines and polygons to digitize. So I'll just have the state capitals, which is the capital of every state. So that will be represented by points and the name. That will be text. So we say finish. So now there we have it. We can start to digitize. So to digitize, we come to the editor toolbar and we start editing. So now it's asking me, this map contains data from more than one database. So I can just click the state capital and automatically it picks everything that are within that database for me. So I say okay. So now I can start digitizing. So I would like to zoom to Lagos State. So this is what Lagos State looks like. Let me just go back to the previous extent. And let me zoom to Ogun and Lagos State together. So this is what it looks like. So to digitize, I'll come to this create feature. If you can't find it here, come to create feature and I'll just pin it since I'll be using it a lot. So to digitize, I'll just pick the states. To digitize the states, I'll just pick the states and I'll start from this junction and I'll trace along. So at the end of it, I double click. So there we have Lagos. So I like populating my attributes immediately. So I come to the attributes, and then for the name, I have it Lagos. For the population, I input the population, say 25 million. Then for the geopolitical zone. All right, so I should have picked long integer. So the short integer can't take more than 5 characters. So I just reduce it to 5 characters. So you shouldn't make that mistake while you creating yours. So for the geo zone, it's southwest. Lagos is in southwest Nigeria. So I just leave that, and now I continue digitizing. So I come back to my create features. Now, since Lagos State is bordering Ogun State, we don't have to digitize around this part of Ogun State again. So what we'll do is to select state here, and we see a feature called autocomplete polygon. So that's what we'll be using. So to use autocomplete polygon, we pick a point within Lagos, then we start digitizing Ogun State. So I'm really being very fast, but when you are digitizing yours, you should be like more careful and follow the paths. So when you get to the edge, instead of looking at the edge, you can come inside Lagos State to complete the polygon, then you double click. So there we have it, we have Lagos, we have Ogun. So I'll go back to the attributes to populate the attributes. So the name, Ogun, the population, just puts a random value. Then the geo zone is also southwest. So that's how I would digitize and would populate for the entire country. But for this tutorial, I won't be going around the entire country. I'll be using a previously digitized map of Nigeria to further explain. So I was going to talk to you about layers. So this is a layer, this is also a layer, this is also a layer. These are layers here. So what a layer means, a layer is a visual representation of a geographic information based on a theme, such as road, buildings, and whatever we may have. So a layer is basically a visual representation of a geographic information. So that is what a layer is. So now in this video, we've learned how to digitize and also populate our attributes table.